So we went south, toward Chile. I guess Aguirre had some friends in high places, because there were U.S. tanks waiting for us. We hadn't had support in a long time, so it felt a little like Christmas. Except our present was a crazy Russian colonel. Truth is, I'd had worse holidays.
Bravo 2, this is River Guard. Come in, over.
Go ahead, River Guard.
Yurilenko's last known position puts him in a settlement, possibly a compound, near the Talonate wind farms. Do whatever you can to take him alive. But you know the drill. Do what you have to do.
Understood, River Guard. Bravo 2, out.
Kodiak 3, we're changing routes. Welcome to the Red Zone.
Alright. Welcome to part 7 of Bakhmut 2 Let's Play. Let's make this more interesting and exciting, shall we? I'm not gonna talk like that the entire time. Because that's silly. Yes, we finally get to drive tanks! I love tanks. Although, Bakhmut 2 tanks are kind of weird. There we go. Yes, yes, yes. So yeah, this is what Bakhmut. Oh, hold on. How can I switch weapons? No, I guess I can't switch weapons. Oh well. Man, I'm so used to Battlefield 3 tanks, so this is kind of weird and off-putting a little bit. But yeah. So this is what Battlefield should be all about. It's about driving tanks in large, open-ended levels. Like, I hate this multiplayer map. Like, this very same map exists in multiplayer and it's called Heavy Metal or something, and as a multiplayer map, I genuinely hate it. I think it's garbage because it's way too plain. There's not a lot of stuff going on. There's not enough cover because, you know, it's not as, perhaps, there isn't as much hills as I would like there to be, because it just ends up looking like a plain field almost, and that leaves you very, very open to various, if you're an infantry, it leaves you open to enemy tanks and enemy snipers, and this map is always filled with fucking douchebag snipers. So not a fan of this map in the multiplayer, but in single player, I fucking love this map, this level, whatever you want to call it. Because it is so much fun. It's large and open-ended, and you get to drive vehicles. That's how it should be. That's how Battlefield single player should be. Battlefield single player should not be in shitty linear corridors like Battlefield 3 and, you know, to a certain extent 4 does it. Okay, what is up with this objective mark? Kill enemy tow launchers, yeah, okay. Pretty sure everyone's dead. Oh, there we go, now it moved on, that's weird. Maybe it waited for the bloody, you know, NPCs to arrive and shit. Yeah, now we can use the UAV, a little oddball chopper. But, oh, jeez. I've never really used UAV that much on PC. I played this game mostly on console, and you know, I've played a little bit of multiplayer on PC as well, but the movement system, you know, it really feels like it wasn't. It's so odd that you can't strafe diagonally or run diagonally by using, you know, W and A and W and D at the same time. You can basically just run forward by using W, and it's weird and off-putting, and some people attribute that to consoles because the analog sticks, it was made for analog sticks in mind. I'm like, what are you talking about? Because Battlefield 3 and 4 and so on, they have the diagonal strafing or whatever you want to call it, and it works great with controllers. Bakhmut 2 feels just as awkward with a controller as it feels with keyboard and mouse when it comes to movement specifically. So I just don't understand what people are rabbling about when they say, oh, it was built with your controllers in mind, and oh, this is a bit difficult to control. Come on, just... Man, I think my mouse sensitive is way too high for this shit. Because obviously I adjusted my sensitivity to, for, you know, with infantry aiming in mind specifically, not so much for, like, UAV stuff and whatnot. There's a tank. I might as well take it out. There we go. Yeah. But yeah, this single player level is genuinely fun. Like, it's just fun. Oh, jeez, man. UAV is very close to dying. I wish I could see the percentage. Oh, never mind. Doesn't matter. Because, you know. Because we succeeded. But, this single player level is something I genuinely enjoy. It's fun, it's huge, there's vehicles, you get various gadgets to play as to play with, and it's just great. And this is what a Battlefield single player should be about. Although it is obviously still very much scripted, and Battlefield 3, I think, kinda attempts these kinds of levels. You know, there's a tank mission, there's the horrible jet mission. Oh my god. At some point, I feel like I'll have to do an LP of Battlefield 3 single player just so I can point out just how awful it is. I don't want to. If I was unenthusiastic and dying about Battlefield 2 single player, just imagine the suffering that is Battlefield 3 single player. Oh, thanks! Another thing I should probably apologize about, or for, is the microphone quality, the audio quality just in general when it comes to this entire Let's Play, not about this part specifically, but about the entire Let's Play, because, you know, obviously part 1 and 2 had pretty shitty microphone quality, and then part 3 and 4 had even worse, and then part 5 was better, but a little bit echoey, and I don't even know what's going to be the quality for part 6 and 7, so, you know, I got a new microphone. This microphone's pretty good. Still no pop filter, which is upsetting. Because, you know, it's coming from Hong Kong, so it's probably going to arrive, you know, by the year 2027 or something, but it's a thing that exists, so, you know, hopefully at some point I'll get the pop filter or whatever, but More importantly than that, hopefully this microphone, and hopefully the way I've set up this microphone this time around, because like last time, part 5. In part 5, despite me using a very good microphone, the audio quality sounds very echoey and stuff, and it's because it was kind of not too far away from me, but it was, you know, reasonably far away from my mouth and whatnot, and I guess my room really is kind of bad when it comes to acoustics and shit, but, you know, whatever. This entire LP is, you know, it's my first LP, and it shows, experimentation, different kinds of tech, and, so on, and blah blah blah. Hopefully my second LP, or whatever, will be better, and, you know, hopefully it will be more interesting, because I'll, presumably, will have another person with me, so I'm not gonna have to carry, goddammit, Road, you block my fun. Really am I stuck? Okay, let's just back out, I guess. Kind of wanted to be cool and take shortcuts, but no. You're not allowed to be cool. I have a second LP in mind, and for it to be more interesting, I'm gonna have another person with me who hopefully will feel the silence when I'm too tired or annoyed to speak or don't can't come up with anything interesting to say, like right now! oh jeez. Okay, where's the next objective marker? Oh, there we go. This game is weird when it comes to triggering the actual things, and oh great, it's one of those missions where... you know, I really hate this about modern military shooters. Point the binoculars, and click. And then just let literally the NPCs do all the hard work. I was praising this level. I genuinely like the single player level. You know, the bits where you're driving a tank and you're controlling a tank and shooting shit. Those are the bits I actually like. This bit, on the other hand, I could deal without because yeah, this is not fun. Like staring with binocs and then pointing and clicking. It's not fun. It's also not particularly representative of how Mortar Strike works in the multiplayer. Yes, in the multiplayer you pull out your binocs and you point and click, but I don't know, like, they have these mechanics that slide, you know, that almost resemble the multiplayer mechanics, but they're different, so it's not really a good tutorial. And unlike the old classic Battlefield games like Battlefield 1942 and Battlefield 2, you don't have bot matches. You can't just, you know, have bot matches and play basically multiplayer in. You can play multiplayer matches offline, essentially, because the server or the level, whatever you want to call it, gets filled with bots, and you get to learn about games' multiplayer mechanics that way. I think bots is probably the best. I honestly think bot matches are like the best tutorial levels without being tutorial levels. Because, like, normally tutorial levels are like specifically designed, you know, cut from everything else types of, like, you know, levels or rooms where game goes out of the way to explain the mechanics and shit. When you have bot matches, when you have the options to use bots, you don't need tutorial levels, you don't need lengthy tutorials, you don't need shitty boring single-player campaigns to vaguely give you a glimpse of the multiplayer mechanics and gimmicks. You just play against bots, and, you know, if you're new to the series or franchise and you're not familiar how stuff works, you can learn. You can put bots on easy or medium or whatever, and you can just learn about the mechanics that way. Not so much, you know, nowadays, where bot matches are incredibly rare. And I guess we're gonna be proceeding on feet. It's a shame. I wish I could use... Can I actually get into this tank? I doubt it, but it would be great. Of course I can't. Of course I cannot get into it. What a shame. But yes. I'm really sad that bots are no longer a thing in multiplayer games. I mean, Overwatch has bots, actually, but it's kind of shitty that that game is always online, so... Yeah, you can play against bots, but you still need to be connected to the internet. Which sucks, because... You know, what if my internet goes down? What if whatever happens and, let's say, I'm without... an access to an internet for a couple days? In old Battlefield games, in classic Battlefield games, and, you know, a bunch of other old shooters, you could just start up bot matches, because you didn't need to... connect to online servers or shit. Just start up bot matches and have fun and fuck that fucking... Jesus Christ, that fucking... What's it called? Stationary gun or whatever. Oh, there's a bathtub blocking my way. Okay. Can I shoot this sort of thing? No. That's weird. Like, that is genuinely fucking weird. I'm seeing this gun icon on my minimap, and I'm, like, looking for it. Oh, there it is. Yeah. Ah, Jesus Christ. Like, how do you... Like, I get it, I have a fucking grenade launcher, but... Where are you? There you are. That seemed a bit too low, but whatever. Got hit markers, but there we go. Oh, come on, this is fairly annoying. I'm sorry, I have to deal with this shit. Oh, come on, is it? He's still not dead. Jesus Christ! And, like, this level, like, there is no good place to get cover from. So. Oh, that dodge. That missile dodge, though. Fucking... Okay, can we please? Thank you. That missile dodge, though. That was pretty fun. Let's move on. And I love how these useless, you know, NPCs just not really taking cover or anything. And that mounted gunner couldn't shoot them. He always shot at me, like... Ah, don't you just love single players and shooters? Don't you just love them? Aren't you just happy how they replaced bot matches? I'm sorry, I'm raving about it too much. But yes. Okay, that's NPCs. I get scared. I thought that was enemies. Good old ammo pile. So yeah, this is actually a fairly interesting looking level. We went from from a plain fields, whatever, meadow with hills, to basically a mountain city. No, not really a city, it's more like a town really. And oh yeah, it's in Chile, they said.
He knows where Kirilenko is, and he says he'll tell us if we let him go.
All right, give us a few seconds, huh?
Hey, how long you reckon?
10 seconds.
Four. Five. Bingo.
Rally up, fellas. Okay, I've got Kirilenko's location. Marines, we're gonna need your Humvees and your shooters.
Whatever you need, sir.
What'd you say to that prisoner, Sergeant?
Nothing. Just told him why we were here.
He just gave it up.
Yep. Said he had family in Houston.
Tex. Sometimes people are just people, man.
Mount up.